sensed God calling you to reach out to someone, to maybe initiate reconciliation with someone who was upset with you, and maybe according to your perception, without cause, and who you knew, you were 90% certain would not respond well to your efforts, that they would in effect reject you. And if so, how did you respond? What made that situation so challenging? And what were the results? But maybe most importantly, what did that interchange teach you about Christ? Hi, I'm Jennifer Slattery. I'm an iBelieve writer, and I'm also the host of Life Audio's Faith Over Fear podcast. And years ago, a woman became upset with me. And as I contemplated the situation, as I prayed over the situation, I sensed that the issue stemmed more from a miscommunication, from faulty perceptions, and from more that was going on inside the woman. So I prayed for her, and I sensed God calling me to reach out, and I did. And I tried to follow Jesus' commands in Matthew 18, where he says, you know, if we have conflict with someone, we're to seek that person out, we're to take the initiative and to seek reconciliation. And if that doesn't work, we're to bring one other person along and again, seek reconciliation. So I tried that and with no response, I thought, well, I did my part. Everything's great and I can move on. But about a week later, I was praying and I sensed God putting this woman on my heart. And so I began to pray for her. And as I did, I once again sensed him calling me to reach out. And so I did. I'm like, okay, I'll try again. And this went on a few times. And after like the third or fourth time, I'm like, Lord, no, why? Like, why would you have me do this? She obviously does not want to have a conversation. She doesn't want to have anything to do with me. I didn't really like the idea of initiating rejection. But I sensed him saying to me that he was doing a deep, deep work within her, more than I could see just from this situation. There was a lot more going on with her. And most importantly, that he was using me, that he was using this interaction to demonstrate his persevering, initiating, sacrificial, reconciling love. And so I reached out to her again. And you might be familiar with Jesus's instructions on how we're to handle conflict. Like I said, we're to go to the person first. And if that doesn't work, we're to bring somebody else into the situation, but we are to take initiative to seek conflict resolution. But here's what I find beautiful. You have to remember, Jesus was speaking, he spoke these words in context of a bigger dialogue, and listen to what he said directly before his conflict resolution passage. This is Matthew 18, verses 12 through 13. He said, if a man has 100 sheep and one of them wanders away, what will he do? Won't he leave the 99 others on the hills and go out to search for the one that is lost? And if he finds it, I tell you the truth, he will rejoice over it more than over 99 that didn't wander away. Now we know that's the analogy he's making is that he's the good shepherd and he is searching for each one of us. He's seeking each one of us out to bring us back into his sheepfold, if it were. And he did nothing wrong. Like, we have no cause to be angry at him, to run from him, to rebel from him. And yet he seeks us out. And that really put my interaction with this woman in context. And now she never did respond in the way that I hoped, and reconciliation never occurred. But I believe God continued the work that he began in her, using others to show her that same initiating and persevering and reconciling love. And I think sometimes we forget the bigger picture, that God, if we belong to Jesus, God has given us the message of reconciliation. And we are what's called his ambassadors. We reflect him in what we do and how we speak and how we interact. And so as we're reconciling with others, regardless of how they respond to our efforts, we are demonstrating the initiating, reconciling love of our Savior.